Gatorade. Setting the floor for the Bucks. We've got John Henson. Greg Monroe is out there with Andy the Kuma. And there's Terry. And it's Middleton in at the two. The shot's good from Henson.
And he's on the board early. The first to strike there. Nice hoop.
And here are the Raptors now. Here's Lowry. He dishes a two to Rosen. There's a good screen. And that ball, nice shot that time from Kyle Lowry.
Kyle Lowry, an inside-outside scoring factor. Every three-point shooter, despite his relatively short stature, he's able to drive inside and finish effectively because of that good strength.
Here's Antetokounmpo, a wide open look here for Jim. Drops one in from the wing. Here's Lowry. First quarter, just over a minute played. DeRozan, a three-ball. Rebounded by the Bucks. For Lowry, not much of an in-between game, but that probably do something.
Yeah, he gets to that rim beyond the arc. That's really where he makes his pay. As long as you can do it the way he does, the mid-range game is something you can work on later.
So even from here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
Yep, pretty obvious. The official.
Howard DeRozan, a first-team All-Star last year, improved his long-range shooting. And wing threes up around 40%, and that allowed him to shoot the best overall three-point percentage of his career.
DeRozan last season cracking 30% from long-range for the first time in his young, promising career. That outside shot has been the missing part of his offensive game, because we know he can get to the rack.
Now here's DeRozan. Shot is good that time. DeRozan's got 5 points.
He's off to a good start, and he's a guy who we know if it gets going early, no problems all day.
Terry gets to Middleton. He's looking for Monroe and finds him. Serge Ibaka with the rebound. Sets a screen for Terry. Jumper off the screen and another basket for
reset button. And so they trade away Rudy Gay and Andrea Bargnani, and the team actually played better than ever.
Off the mark here with the three-point shot. Raptors trailed by six. They can use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Good, good, Kevin. I mean, too many of the trip. They need to come.
Especially with the Raptors' history of losing their star players, whether it's Tony or Chris Bosh. There's a player who wanted to play for the Raptors, but you know, the odds were always against that. In the end, you know, they did what they were supposed to do, and that's win games.
Out of bounds, Milwaukee takes possession.
Well, he just didn't make the catch, didn't look the ball into his hands. He must have thought the ball was going somewhere else.
Well, when you're the worst team in the league, extension from the Raptors. I think they've got to be pleased with this part.
Joseph, he's checked in for Kyle Lowry. Big group substitution here for Milwaukee. Spencer Hawes has checked in for John Henson. Under Gumton for Blake Monroe. Chris Mills checked in for Adam Kadumbo. And it's Mayo in for Chris Middleton. Parker's shot is off. And guys, when you look at DeRozan, where can he take the next step?
Well, he has the physical tools to be an elite perimeter defender. Strides, definitely. He has the potential, I think, to be even better than what he is right now.
And it's Terry, the drive. And shot opportunity. And so he draws the foul on the shot. And he's on the line to shoot two.
Pretty bad defense, letting the offense get right to the rim. Smart play foul once he was there.
You know it's going to happen. They sent a message right there. Nothing easy inside.
Parker, self-described obedient kid growing up in Chicago, maintained a 3.7 GPA through high school. Moving so far as to say he had low self-esteem in his junior days. You don't often hear about junior days, but it's reality. Believe me, I've seen these guys.
There's no reason for this guy to doubt his worth now, especially on the basketball.
And here's Parker. In the game. Down low.
competitive.
Yeah, extremely competitive and confident and certain. His talent and those attributes, he's got a guy that looks like he could be a potential all-star.
Toronto have gone 8 of 15 from the field, shooting above 50% here tonight. Now, here's Joseph. Terry covering. DeRozan shoots.
That's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
I just love the mentality. The shot isn't there.
Thank you.
giveaways. That's excellent pressure and good activity with the hand.
They've got Damari Carroll. DJ Tucker is up there. Patrick Patterson. And it's Vasquez. And it's Lowry in at the point guard. That's the five out there for the Raptors. Here's Snell. Lowry covering.
To DeRozan.
Nice ball movement here by the Raptors. Neal brings the double team. Carroll gets the line. And the Raptors hit again from deep. Ron Lauer, one of the more underrated players in the NBA, but he's also not going to deal with coaches in the last 2 years.
You know, some locker room concerns and you can rub folks the wrong way, but I tend to always want to give the player the benefit of the doubt in this situation until you know for sure what the issues are. Nothing wrong with being saying that.
In this one.
His shooting's been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons his team is up in this game.
Here's Antetokounmpo. He has 6. He visits the park. Good job on the post. Like a lot of give and take between these sides early.
Kevin, how about 6 lead changes in this half already?
Good one here, guys. This is going to be fun to watch. Two equally matched. Both teams are
hard. Here it gets to DeRozan.
Excellent timing and really an innate sense of when to rush in for the weak side shot this good game. And he just seems to usually be in the right place at the right time. And that's what we call a basketball sense.
Jason Terry has checked in for Milwaukee. Knocked loose. Next break, Toronto. Carroll's running. And the shot counts. He's fouled. It's a chance for a 3-point play. And look at how the hustle game has been going for the Raptors.
Well, I think the defensive aggressiveness on display here has caught him off guard, playing airtight defense and coming up with the steal.
And the other thing they're doing is forcing a lot of turnovers, and that's helping them to get easy points at the other end.
The Bucks making a change here. Hawes is checked in. They set the pick. And his luck deep. With that shot, the Raptor lead is cut down. Just 2 points on the bucket from Antetokounmpo.
Perfect screen there to set him up. Nice look.
Poor job by the defender to not fly over or around that screen.
This shot by Lowry, no good.
Although given that shot, he doesn't have the most reliable jump shot in the world. We know that.
Antetokounmpo dishes to Hawks. Terry gets to Antetokounmpo. He's at Middleton. Shot clock at 6. Steve, 8 lead changes now, and we're still just in the first half.
You know, both teams showing a lot of resilience, I think. Coming back and coming back, back and forth, back and forth.
Shot. Now down Terry, wide open. And Jen shot, and it's blocked by Ibaka. And it's out of bounds. The Raptors will check it the other way. Pass was checked in for the Raptors. P.J. Tucker comes in for Damari Carroll. Milwaukee also making some changes. Craig Monroe, he's checked in for Antetokounmpo. And Tony Snell subbed in for Chris Middleton. Hands for him. That's good. Terry with it. 11 points in the game. To the paint. Picked off in midair. One on one here. Here's Hansbrough. That's in. Coming off an assist from Lowry. Now it's a 6-point Toronto lead.
You know, it's really hard not to notice the difference in the passing of these two teams today.
Yeah, look at the discrepancies. The assist column.
But I still think the future's bright for him.
He doesn't get the second one.
And for Valanciunas last season, a drop in field goal and free throw percentage. While he's rebounding a hoop, he's still learning NBA defense, struggling at times against pick and rolls and various things.
And that one's good. Tucker.
Really hard to find fault with anything he's doing this quarter, at least at the offensive.
Over to the left wing.
Thank you.
assists. I had no idea we'd be seeing a performance like this one today.
Totally dominant. I mean, pure domination.
Getting underway in the second half, here's the five for Jason Kidd. Antetokounmpo out there with Monroe. Then it's Chris Middleton. Then it's John Henson. And it's Terry in at the point. Patterson dishes to Hansbrough. And that one's good. Hansbrough's got the first bucket of the third here for Toronto.
Beautiful feed off the bounce to his teammate there. Nicely done.
Middleton to pass to Monroe. Dishes to Terry. To Monroe. And he takes it into the lineup off a very nice feed.
Good example there of some fine interior passing before that pass.
And Tucker has it in the corner. The dish to Vasquez. Right wing, shot clock at six. Offensive rebound, picks it out to Johnson. Toronto working the ball around now. Patterson with it. Get on Henson. Hansbrough inside. Another shot. And Henson pulls it down. Henson's got his third out tonight. And Middleton gets the tip. And we're about to the half here. Into the second half. Again, it's Milwaukee converted.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
I think it's time to make some adjustments defensively. But what they've got going right now is not
getting the basket. Raptors lead by seven.
The basket, man, what an example of tremendous passing.
Bucks obviously did not have a great season on the court, but off the court, they were some big things as the franchise was sold. That's it.
Middleton dishes to Terry. It's Terry again missing. He's leading by seven. Here's Vasquez. It's thrown by Antetokounmpo. Patterson against Terry. He kicks to Antetokounmpo. Back to Terry. It's thrown by Hansbrough. The basket. Fires the three. Milwaukee with a rebound. Johnson's got four rebounds in this game. And with the Bucks in their sale, new ownership. What's important is that you notice that it's a local group and they're continuing to really get the tentacles within the community.
Well said, and that's always helpful when you have ownership that's there present and invested in the local community. There's a lot of fear in Milwaukee that the team could be on the move.
Terry. Ask Jolanda Jacumbo. DeRozan. They set the screen. Great use of the pick to create room for the jumper. DeRozan's got 23 points.
Boy, they were helpless defensively.
The pass to Mayo. Mayo left side. Good. Mayo's got 15 points. Now Mayo, he's got 17. single-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Raptors lead by 13. We'll be back shortly live from the Air Canada Center in downtown Toronto. And a chance right now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
Well, today it comes from the men in the middle. Yeah, let me tell you, anytime you get a big man who can pass like this, it really changes the way you can play offense. It diversifies your offensive attack.
Let me ask, who is the best passing big man you've played with? Australian.
Yes. Good redhead. Good passing.
Number one hit by Minnesota Timberwolves. Corey Joseph is out there with DeRozan. Then it's P.J. Tucker. And it's Ibaka. And it's Nogueira in at the five spot. Number five out there for the Raptors.
How well he led him there with that pass.
Now Joseph. Left side. DeRozan. No good off of Ron Ivey.
You see his balance there? That's really fading away.
Every season, you really have to admire his work ethic. Everybody raves about the character of this man.
That's what Toronto's going with right now. Thompson comes in for DeMar DeRozan, and it's Lowry and Joseph. Jabari Parker. points in the bucket from Terry.
He's simply a machine at the offensive end. I wonder how far behind they'd be if he wasn't having this kind of play.
Got 1:23 left in the fourth.